अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द यूजेस ऑफ आइसोटॉप्स। सो देयर आर फाइव बेसिक यूजेस ऑफ आइसोटॉप्स, वी डिस्कस वन बाय वन। द फर्स्ट वन इज द रेडियोथेरेपी। सो बिफोर वी गो ऑन फर्दर एंड बिफोर वी स्टार्ट इट इन डिटेल, वी शुड नो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ रेडियोएक्टिव एलिमेंट्स। सो द एलिमेंट्स दैट इमिट radiations are known as radioactive elements. Okay, radioactive elements. So what are the radioactive elements? The elements that emit radiation are known as radioactive elements. So basically in radiotherapy method we use the radioactive elements. So now let us read. For the treatment of a cancer, isotopes like p32 and the cerium-90 are used because they emit the penetrating beta radiations. So these are the two basic isotopes. These are the radioactive isotopes and emit radiation. So these are used for the skin cancer treatment because they emit less penetrating beta radiations. Why we use those isotopes that are less penetrating? Because we use the less penetrating, because if we use the highly penetrating radiations and highly penetrating isotopes, then it may be damage the organs of your body, internal organs of your body. So that's why we use those isotopes that are less penetrating beta radiations. So for cancer, cobalt 60 affecting within the body is used because it's emits strongly penetrating gamma rays. So whenever you want to know about the internal organs, then you use the high penetrating isotopes, that is a cobalt 60. Okay, as I already told you that whenever you want to know about the internal organs, then we use the highly penetrating radiations, radioactive isotopes. And if we want to treatment, if we want to do the treatment of a skin cancer, then we use the less penetrating isotopes like p32 and cerium 90. So the next one is the traces for diagnosis and medicine. So how we trace or diagnose any disease in our body? So that is also possible with the help of radioactive isotopes. The radioactive isotopes are used as a traces in medicine, so to diagnose the presence of a tumor in the human body. So some radioactive isotopes are also used in medicines to find out the tumor, where the tumor exists in the human body. Isotopes of iodine-131 are used for diagnosis of goiter in thyroid gland. You know that goiter is a disease that is caused due to the high amount of salt, due to the low deficiency and of the salt. So in this disease we use the iodine-131 for the diagnosis and for the treatment. Similarly, technetium is used to monitor the bone growth. So many technetium is also used to monitor the bone growth, to find out about the growth of the bone. So in that monitor we also use the isotopes. The third one is archaeological and geological uses. We also use the radioactive isotope to find out the age and to find out the fossil fuels of many living organisms. So now let us see how is it possible. The radioactive isotopes are used to estimate the age of fossils like dead plants and animals and stones. The age determination is of very old object based on the half leaves of the radioactive isotope is called radioactive isotope dating. It's a very very important definition that what is radioactive isotope dating. If we used radioactive isotope to find out the age, based on the half leaves of the radioactive isotope is known as radioactive isotope dating. Okay, an important method of age determination of old carbon containing object by measuring the radioactive of carbon 14 in them is called radiocarbon dating or simply carbon dating. So if we used the isotope of carbon 14, then it is known as radiocarbon dating. Okay. So the third one is the chemical reaction and structure determination. If we find out the chemical reaction of any elements or a compounds, and if you find out the structure of any element, then we use the isotope also. So now let us see how the radioisotopes are used in a chemical reaction to follow a radioactive element during the reaction and ultimately to determine the structure. So whenever we start any reaction, we use the radioactive isotope in it to find out the structure and to find out the reaction of that element or that specific element. For example, carbon 14 is used to label carbon dioxide. As carbon dioxide is used by the plants for photosynthesis to form glucose, its movement is detected through the various intermediate steps up to glucose. So when carbon dioxide with the help of a water and with the help of a light change into the glucose, so during that process we use the radioactive isotope to find out its reaction and to find out the structure that we get at the end of the reaction. Okay, so the fifth one is, and the last one, uses the application in power generation. So how we generate electricity and how we generate power generation with the help of isotope. Let us see. Radioactive isotopes are used to generate electricity by carrying out controlled nuclear fission reaction in nuclear reactors. So whenever we used nuclear reactors, nuclear elements in nuclear fission reaction, that process is used to generate electricity. For example, when uranium-235 is bombarded with slow moving neutrons, okay, the uranium nucleus breaks up to produce barium and krypton-94 and these three neutrons. So when uranium is reacted with the neutron, then it produces barium and the krypton and the three more neutrons also, plus energy also. So at the end we generate energy that is used for the electricity purpose and for the power generation. A large amount of energy is released, which is used to convert water and into steam in boilers. So that energy we use to boil the water and to change the water into the steam. So that steam then drives the turbines to generate electricity. This is the peaceful use of atomic energy for development of a nation. So this is a very simple method how we generate the electricity, how we generate power with the help of a radioactive isotopes. Okay, so I hope you understand the basic uses of the isotopes. Take care and Allah Hafiz.